Domus, a world of peace where all races lived in harmony until one fateful night when the sky lit up. Embers rained from the heavens. Millions beyond count fell to the ground, their fiery tails and gleaming crystal slamming into the earth for what felt like eons. The people of Domus hid, fearing this terrible omen. But one race, whose curiosity knew no bounds, ventured forth. The Lightbringers felt the magic contained in these stones. The more they studied, the greater these fallen embers seemed. They were more than just beautiful. They were alive. And so a special bond was formed between the Lightbringers and their magical companions, the Embers. A bond so true, no other race could replicate it. Jealousy grew, and it led to war. The dwarves mined for Ember, digging deep into the earth where they had landed and hoarding all they could find. They sold them to eager elves and men who drained them of their life force, using their magical power for selfish gain and wearing the spent stones as jewelry and trinkets. Many forgot the embers were even alive and sought their beauty and the energy within. But not all. The monks of Radiance remembered the old ways, remembered the Lightbringer teachings, and sought to save the embers from their terrible fate. For the embers had become part of Domus in more ways than one, and their dwindling numbers and looming extinction might herald doom for all. But the monks could not do this alone. To save the embers, they would need those who knew their secrets. They would need to awaken the greatest Lightbringer Domus had ever known.
The ritual should have worked!
Some of the thieves left, or thinned their own ranks for us. Please let them be gone. Please let them be gone.
Oh no, they're down here.
Who are you talking about?
I thought we were hired to loot this place.
A fight!
Oh yeah, I love it. You're all gonna die.
This isn't so hard.
Are there any more?
Read plenty of books on fighting. I shall need to sharpen my blade after that tussle. The goddess of Ember protect me.
Oh yeah! Take that!
Never thought I'd die.
Let's get out of here.
Stupid Orkin. Take my book. He was never Olagar's friend.
You're not wanted here. Yes? Oh, he's mine.
Monkhood would be this bloody. I need a healer. Anyone have any healing potions?
Boy, I get
Monkhood in this.
You're still alive. Pain is life, my friend. Glad we made it out of that one alive.
Someone has to guard this loot.
Agreed.
You're mine. Scared? I'm just getting started.
Thank the goddess that's over. Maybe I'm brave after all. Do you think that will happen a lot? I have heard tell of these ancient alcoves. Do not touch that book! It is cursed. He seems to have died from reading that book. Sharpen my blade after that tussle. I wonder what purpose these shrines serve. Thank you.
This is the exit. We are free of this place.
Thank you, gods. We are out.
You're a sight.
What can I do for you?
How can we help you today? Are you looking for anything in particular?
Thank you.
The dwarves mined for Ember, digging deep into the earth where they had landed and hoarding all they could find. They sold them to eager elves and men who drained them of their life force, using their magical power for selfish gain and wearing the spent stones as jewelry and trinkets. Many forgot the embers were even alive and Domus, a world of peace where all races lived in harmony until one fateful night sought their beauty and the energy within. But not all. The monks of Radiance remembered the old ways, remembered the Lightbringer teachings, and sought to save the embers from their terrible fate. For the embers had become part of Domus in more ways than one. And their dwindling numbers and looming extinction might herald doom for all. But the monks could not do this alone. The more they studied, the greater these fallen embers seemed. They were more than just beautiful. They were alive. And so a special bond was formed between the Lightbringers and their magical companions, the embers. A bond so true, no other race could replicate it. Jealousy grew, and it led to war. Night, when the sky lit up, and embers rained from the heavens. Millions beyond count fell to the ground, their fiery tails and gleaming crystal slamming into the earth for what felt like eons. The people of Domus hid, fearing this terrible omen. But one race, whose curiosity knew no bounds, ventured forth. The Lightbringers felt the magic contained in these stones,